Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. The December edition of the Angular Q&A session took place, and this time there were three members of the Angular team present: Mark Thompson, Jeremy Elborn, and Kirill Cherkashin. The episode was mainly about signal forms, which were introduced in version 21 and are still experimental. Kirill mentioned that
I don't expect any huge changes, but I'm not signing my name under that. But like immediately, we don't expect anything break. A lot of feedback was like really weird cases.
But Kirill also pointed out that signal forms are already used in some of Google's internal applications. Another question was about a more advanced daytime picker in Angular Material. And here Jeremy meant that it's currently not possible because of the different locales, but
can you have an Angular Material day picker without relying on an external library for daytime stuff? That would require the temporal API to land in the browser.
There was also a question about selectorless components, which would allow us to refer to a component's class name instead of the selector itself. Here, this feature has been down prioritized because of all the work the Angular team is currently doing towards AI. Another very interesting podcast on signal forms were at AngularAir, where Sander Elias gave quite a detailed overview. He prepared quite a complicated forms example. You could actually call it a kitchen sink. The source code for his example is also available. And AngularAir also hosted Wagner Marciel. Wagner is responsible for the Angular Aria package. Let's hear the definition from him.
Angular Aria is a set of headless, meaning like completely unstyled, accessibility primitives. There's a role combo box, there's a role menu, a role grid, right? We want to take the responsibility of implementing the accessibility behind those roles.
A special feature about Angular Aria is that its foundation is framework agnostic, which means it could also be used in other frameworks. For example, Google is already using it for its internal framework with Angular Material will not be rewritten by using Angular Aria. It is more likely, if there are new components coming up, that they will be based on Angular Aria. There is also the question about the relationship between Angular Aria, Angular CDK, and Angular Material.
What is Material? We would have this like functionality accessibility layer at the bottom, maybe like a wrapper for some of the APIs to be a bit cleaner and only the things that we want to expose. And then the styles portion at the top of the cake, you know, and ta-da, you have Angular Material again.
PrimeNG, a popular UI library, was also released for Angular 21. And it wasn't just an update of the dependencies. The changelog says that it now supports zoneless, provides an easy way to pass through properties to the underlying DOM element, like Aria or the data prefixes, and introduces unstyled components, which seem similar to what Angular CDK offers. Earlier this year, there were plans to come up with a second edition, which was called PrimeNGX. These plans have been dropped, and now the focus is fully on PrimeNG itself. And we also got two new security issues, which have already been fixed. When using the HTTP client to send a request, Angular performs an internal check to see if the request targets the same origin where the application is served. If the request uses a relative URL, the HTTP client automatically adds a CSRF token to the header to verify the request originated explicitly from the user. In the reported security issue, this token was leaked because protocol relative URL was wrongly seen as a relative import. Fixes are already available for the versions 19, 20, and 21. Another security issue was found in Angular's template system. Certain attributes in SVG bypassed the sanitization check, which means that a potential attacker could add malicious JavaScript code. That issue has in the meantime also been resolved. And that's it. I wish you a nice week and see you in the next episode. Goodbye.